Thank you for the family of Corporal Groves for inviting me to speak today on behalf of the great state of Colorado, which he served with dignity. We're all part of one big family in the state of Colorado, and last week we lost a member of that family. The shock of this tragedy amidst a record blizzard reminds us of the importance of the work that we do. And it was so amazing to see the representation from police departments and sheriff's departments and deputies from across our entire state representing their departments and showing solidarity with our loss. Corporal Groves died doing what he spent his life doing in different ways, helping, protecting, serving others, serving our neighbors and lending a helping hand. When last week's storm was approaching, Corporal Groves knew this particular area of Interstate 76 would be problematic. So Corporal Groves did what he often did. He volunteered to take the toughest job on the table. And sure enough, when a vehicle skidded off the road, he volunteered to help address it. Corporal Groves was there to help. He was assisting a fellow Coloradan in his time of need when we tragically lost Dan. But it's not how Corporal Groves lost his life that makes him a hero. It's also how he lived his life as a healer, a brother, a son, a partner, a friend, a kind soul with a big heart and clear-eyed sense of purpose. I didn't have the privilege of knowing Corporal Groves personally, but those who knew him well described him to me, and I will share some of those observations with you today. Many of his friends, his family, his co-workers often knew his good work and knew him by different names. To his family, he was Uncle Dan, or more affectionately, Uncle Waldo, after an incident involving the unfortunate combination of a red and white striped shirt and a set of eyeglasses. Uncle Waldo was committed to family and wanted to bring everyone together. He was an old soul, the kind of guy who remembered everyone's birthday, made sure to give them a call, taking the time to send handwritten notes and cards because he knew it would bring people to a smile. He wanted everyone to be included. When a family member was unable to attend Groves Fest, the regular family gathering, Uncle Dan sent them a ticket so they could join in the festivities. In fact, he was so committed to family that Uncle Dan once endured a five-hour taxi ride with no air conditioning through rural Mexico so he could be with the family for his parents' 50th anniversary cruise. To his college friends at St. Norbert and his fraternity brothers in Phi Sigma Kappa, he was known by the name Grover. Grover was known by his college friends as a healer, working as a trainer for the college hockey team. He worked the front desk at the student union. He was the first smiling face that students and visitors would see when they walked in the building. He was the editor of his college yearbook, helping his fellow students memorialize their college experience, knowing that years later they would open that book and thumb through the pages and remember the good times and the smiles they had. Grover was also the go-to DJ on campus. He always worked hard to make sure that everybody was having fun. But he was also the guy you could turn to when you were having a problem. He was there to listen, to comfort, and to help people through. Dan also had a successful career in IT and the private sector. I heard a couple days ago from a mutual friend from the time that I was in IT in Chicago that knew and worked with Dan at Harris Associates. My friend David shared with me that Dan was a really great guy, kind heart, strong work ethic, spiritual, and a problem solver. He was half of a two-person IT department at Harris & Associates in the 90s that's now grown to a 43-person IT department. And when I was sharing a few moments with Dan's parents before this service, Dan's father reminded me how difficult it would be for us to replace Dan as a state trooper. And if it's judging from the experience of Harrison Associates, it took 42 people to replace Dan. So we better get ready for that. My friend David from Chicago also shared that law enforcement was Dan's dream job. And as he was getting older, there were few forces that would consider his application. He was so excited that Colorado did. And we're proud in Colorado for the work that he did to make our state safer and better. At the academy, his friends revived the Grover nickname. He was one of, if not the oldest members of his class, leaving his lucrative IT job in Chicago because he wanted to serve others. This wasn't a financial decision. This wasn't an easy decision to leave many of his family members. But he wanted to serve, he wanted to give back, because to him, being a state trooper wasn't a job, it wasn't a career, it was a calling of service. A calling that he always felt. Service was in Dan's blood. He had served as an inner city school teacher. At one point, father, he even considered becoming a priest. But he decided that the best way that he could serve others with his unique skills and talent and drive was to become a law enforcement officer. So he dedicated himself to his studies and his training, and he became a state trooper. And he threw himself into the work. As a trooper, Corporal Grove was assigned to Clear Creek and Summit counties. So he was no stranger to helping motorists in bad weather, and no stranger to the risks involved. His fellow troopers said he was one of the most positive people that you'd ever meet. He could always find the silver lining, even on the darkest cloud. He was someone who took the job seriously, but never made the mistake of taking himself too seriously. Because beneath that tailored uniform and tight haircut was a goofy guy who could occasionally show up to trainings in pajamas instead of his police sweats because he knew it would give the other troopers a smile. He was always up for a pun or a clever joke. In Dan's Facebook profile photo, he wore a t-shirt that said, "Never trust an atom, they make up everything." He was always laughing with you, never at you. He hosted the annual Christmas party for his fellow troopers and, of course, knew what everyone would want to eat and drink and made sure that everyone had a good time and felt welcome. He exemplified everything you would ever want in a law enforcement officer, a relative, a friend. Whatever you call him, Uncle Dan, Corporal Grove, Uncle Waldo, Grover, we know that Dan made a difference. The public knew him and knows him now and will remember him as Corporal Daniel Howard Groves, a proud member of the Colorado State Patrol, a dedicated public servant who put his life on the line every single day, as his brothers and sisters in blue do, to serve our communities and keep the rest of us safe from harm. On behalf of our grateful state, I offer my sincere condolences to his family, his friends, his colleagues, and everyone whose lives he touched. Former Vice President Joe Biden, a man who's known much grief and buried two children of his own, once said, "There will come a day when the memory of your loved ones brings a smile to your lips before it brings a tear to your eye." My hope for you is that this day for all of us will come sooner rather than later. And based on the life that Dan lived and the joy that he brought to so many others, I know that that day will come sooner still, and the smile that Dan's memory brings to all of our lips is an important part of the legacy that he would have wanted. Thank you.